into the streets of the South Korean capital to voice their outrage over the deal that Japan struck with South Korea over the so-called comfort women. A weekly rally has been held every Wednesday for more than 20 years outside the Japanese embassy, but this is the first since the agreement that has Japan paying some $8 million and neither country to criticize the others for its actions during the war. Now, activists at the rally say that they are not satisfied with the terms of that agreement. This is a story that we've been following closely here on Newsstream. It is estimated that up to 200,000 women were forced to be sex slaves for Japanese soldiers in World War II. As mentioned here on the program last night, the majority were Korean, but other women, they came from China, Taiwan, the Philippines, and Indonesia. Now, Sylvia Yu Friedman is author of Silence No More, Voices of Comfort Women. In her book, she features some of these victims. We want to take a moment to tell you a few of their stories. This is Wan Ai Hua. She was the first Chinese comfort woman survivor to testify in public in China. She was a victim in one of the more than 1,000 comfort stations that were set up across the country. And here is Wang Ehai. She was only 14 years old when she was abducted. And in her testimonial, she says that each woman was raped by at least 5 to 6 soldiers, sometimes even more, and it did not stop. After one soldier left, another one would come in. And Wang, she's seated at the front here, this picture, she goes on to say this, "The soldiers threw me out after 2 months. I was almost dead." And finally, this is Yuan Gailian. She was 17 years old when she was forced into sexual slavery. In her own words, she says, "I have suppressed all this pain and suffering within me for 65 years. These are just a few of the thousands of stories of atrocities these women had to endure during the war.